GNAT Project Manager, Part 10, Pre-Release Overview. Towards the end of each release cycle, after all developers have committed their code to the version control system, the Release and Configuration Manager applies a number of important steps to each subsystem. Many of these steps are completed with the assistance of program scripts. The objective at this stage is to integrate changes from the version into the release and to update artifacts such as object files, source filters, project files, etc., so as to provide a new release baseline for the next development cycle. Let's quickly walk through the steps. 1. Label the release branch in the version control system and copy it to a local release directory on the build server, then map the directory to drive letter R. The copy at the new location is not under version control and read-write access is currently enabled. 2. Create a private view or a snapshot if you're using ClearCase of the release branch in a local version directory on the build server, then map the directory to drive letter V. The version directory is effectively a copy from the repository to the local file system, which includes support for change management. 3. Run a script to compare the new and previous release versions. The differences are analyzed and used to update key artifacts to reflect changes concerning new modules, components, and main programs. It might also be necessary to add new coding rules for use by GNAT check or pragma directives in a configuration file. At the end of this step, the subprogram, all main units, will include a with clause for every main program in the subsystem. With regards to project file updates, you should avoid changing switch settings, especially those switches related to source formatting. 4. Run a script to integrate the updated development artifacts into the release. 5. Validate the release for each subsystem, which requires us to compile all sources and build the subprogram all main units to generate the object alley and binder files on the release drive. Generate the source filters and test the integrity of each one. Remember that source filters only apply to code in the release view. Code that is transferred to the workspace or created in the workspace is not subject to source filtering. Build each executable for the development environment. These images will include information used by the debugger and other tools. Of course, the development environment does not produce library files for sources under development. Only third-party library resources exist in the development environment in the form of static or dynamic library files. Run all available regression tests. This step could take a few hours to complete. Build executable and library archives that are optimized for use in the test and production environments. Check the information level log file. This file contains a single entry for every significant event. Ensure that the error level log file is empty. Obviously, if no errors have occurred, then there's no need to log anything. Hence, an empty file is sufficient to communicate a successful build. And finally, step 6, update the version drive, preferably by means of a script to automate interaction with the change management system. A key benefit of our development strategy is that by providing a pre-built release with selectable module and component filters, we can reduce the computing time in the workspace to a minimum. For large projects involving dozens of developers and millions of lines of code, the time savings accumulated over the course of a month can amount to significant sums of money. Status report. So, where are we? Well, the release was built without a single warning. All regression tests were successful, that is to say, no errors, no warnings. The application runs as expected with correct behavior and good performance. Great. Then the release is ready for production, right? That depends. For commercial applications, the answer is probably yes. For high-integrity applications, no. These two application types differ in that high-integrity software must be measured against standards in order to be certified for use in domains such as avionics, air traffic management, railway control, space vehicles, and high-security systems. Perhaps one of these days, even financial applications will need to qualify. This is the end of part 10.